connected at the roots, to the trunk, to the branches, to the leaves and the way they fly away in wind dances. A frantic seesaw, free fall in midair that represents the floating folly of us all being here. We are complicated creatures, huh?
Come away, 'cause I love my soul.
You know, I wasn't always a real estate agent. This is our old house. Used to live in Calgary, Alberta. That's when being a realtor was just a dream for me. And being out there, I knew it was something I was gonna do and I had a plan and I was sticking to it no matter what. It was definitely not easy. When we lived here, we were broke. And I say this quite a bit to people, but long before I was selling houses, I was selling my personal items. I remember selling jeans to a buddy of mine from high school, selling furniture, doing whatever it took basically to put food on the table for my kids. There was no turning back. I was all in on this. And funny, I bring this with me. You see this here, this milk crate. I used to sit in the basement of this house right here. We heated it with wood and we had our wood for the winter, or so we thought, but it took a lot. It was a cold winter, our first winter back here. And remember the wood pile getting lower and lower and lower. And this milk crate, I've saved it, I've taken it with me. I used to sit on this in front of the furnace. I watched that pile of wood getting lower and lower and lower, and I'm working, but I'm not making very much money trying to pursue real estate. I think I was making like $10 an hour cash, doing work I wasn't very good at. And I used to just sit on here and stare at the fire in the furnace, wondering how I was gonna keep up, wondering how I was gonna feed these kids and while I pursued my dreams. Not 100% sure knowing how it was gonna work out, but I knew there was no way it wasn't. I was gonna do whatever it takes. So I keep this as kind of a reminder of where I used to be, and that was only like 3 years ago. So this is it, this is Martinvale. To answer your question, where did I grow up? This is the place. Me, my mom and dad, 7 brothers and sisters, there's 4 boys and 4 girls. There's 2 younger than me, that's where I fall into the ranks. My younger brother and younger sister, and I got 5 older siblings. So this was life for me as a kid, this is all I knew. I didn't know there was a whole other world outside of here, but anyway. It's funny, you look at this field right here. Come over here, Max. Take a look at the neighbor's house. This was Gordon and Edna Laird. So between their house, we used to run back and forth so many times that we had literally a trail cut in from our feet. From you picture 8 kids, 2 feet, they're 16. To ensure us over there quite a bit, and he'd make us, or ask us to pull weeds out of his driveway, and he'd give us the chocolate freezies for pay. I really didn't get better than that as a kid. It's funny, I haven't seen those since I was a kid. I don't quite remember how many bedrooms were in there. There was 10 of us living there, but I remember sharing a room. And this was life, it was very good. There was no money for, you know, ball teams or hockey or nothing like that, but with 8 kids, you kind of had your own 2 teams of 4 and 4 all the time, so it was fun that way. So this is where the school bus would pick us up every morning, Monday to Friday. Gosh, the driver looks so much smaller now than it used to. To me, this was our baseball diamond kind of thing. I remember playing baseball out here. It's crazy how much smaller it looks now compared to what it used to be. Yeah, it's good. I used to come down here every Saturday morning before work, prepare to get feed, like 5:30, 6 o'clock. Before I was a realtor, that was my last job before I was a realtor. That was the part where I'm like, I want it so bad and it's so close, I can taste it. But I literally didn't even have enough money to get the damn license, let alone maintain my life while I was a realtor. So this whole part was just every Saturday morning, like I said, I'd come down here, I'd read my books, study audio. You know, this was the find my inspiration down here. Life was still, this Cardigan River is absolutely gorgeous. You know, that's where I grew up, so right over here, yellow building. That used to be Wim's. That was pretty much everything we knew as kids. It had everything in there. You get your 5 cent candy. You guys are old enough to remember Sears. Sears used to deliver there. You'd order from the catalog. Those who do remember the Christmas wish book pretty good.
Right here.
Fast forward 3 years later to right now. I remember sitting here. It's funny. Even the clothes I'm wearing right now, these were all thoughts I had. And I knew someday I was gonna get there. Yeah. You gotta have a plan. You gotta know where you're going. And stick with it. You're gonna meet a lot of people who tell you can't do it, and I remember that very, very well, and I just use that for motivation. Push even harder. Here's an interesting story. I remember one of my first few listing appointments, I was so broke, I went to the gas station, and I think I had $4.26, it might have been 36 cents, and that moment I pumped $4 into my piece of shit Honda Civic. And I remember thinking the guy at the counter inside was probably like 16, he had way more money to me, and after the listing appointment on the way home, seeing that fuel light on, and literally praying that God or whoever you want to think it is would carry me home on those fumes, and I would make it home every night. I feel like I came full circle to be here right now. Yeah, this was the wanting phase. So you start with the want, then you take the action, and then you get the results. It's plain and simple. And the people who, you know, in your life think you can't do it that way or don't see the potential in you, those are the ones you really need to get rid of. Focus on the ones who are there to support you. They're out there, trust me. Yeah, Cardigan River. This is it, apocalypse.